That's it! A device which connects an ESP32S2 Mini, an RFM95 LoRa transceiver, an ATGM GPS module and a 0.96-inch OLED display. Furthermore, it has a backup battery for the GPS module, a 16340 LiPo battery with its own charger and a dual LDO voltage regulator setup, which ensures that all the power-hungry modules except the MCU itself can be depowered from the other circuit. This makes it possible that all the other modules doesn't consume any power while the ESP32 is in deep sleep mode. Actually, this design was just a simple test board to work with the GPS module, the LoRa transceiver and the ESP32 S2 Mini, which I have never used before, but in the end, this board can be used as a simple LoRa-based GPS tracker system. In order to do some first tests, I grabbed one of my solar charger PCBs with a corresponding solar panel and a waterproof box, assembled a second device and connected a few sensors to it via the onboard 2 via interface connector. The device will wake up from deep sleep, collect some data which will be published over LoRa to the other device. This one acts like a LoRa to MQTT bridge. After publishing the data, the device will go back to deep sleep. The LoRa message will be sent as a string with separators between the topic and the value, just like a self-implemented JSON package. The data can then be shown in any cloud-based visualization software or, like in my case, in Home Assistant. Here I am just testing it with a battery voltage of the solar charger PCB, which seems to work fine. Over the day, the battery voltage increases due to the sunlight and in the night, the voltage decreases. After I finished the wiring, it was time to do some power measurements. In doing so, I connected the power profiler kit to my Mac and exchanged the battery of the device with the power output of the PPK. During the sensor readings, the device consumes around 90 milliamps and while publishing data over LoRa, the peak current rises to over 200 milliamps. In deep sleep, the device will need around 80 microamps, which is fine, and the device stays connected to the solar system. I haven't tested the GPS module a lot, but it seems to work fine with providing the current position as well as the date and time. Tell me your ideas in the comments below. Where should I integrate this tiny GPS module and where would you use it for? As this was just a simple test board, these three modules will definitely be used in upcoming projects as well. So stay tuned and consider subscribing for more. In the end, I want to thank PCBWay for supporting this little side project. They provided these beautiful matte black PCBs with unique finish. If you want to try their PCB manufacturing, PCB assembly or 3D printing service, just hit the first link in the description and turn your ideas into reality. Don't wait too long because they are just celebrating their 8th birthday with lots of coupons and discounts. Thanks for watching and see you next time!